is a shield. It is a shelter. Shield from evil deeds. Shelter from the hell. And it can save us from the evil deeds in this world and from the hell in the hereafter. But we must safeguard this shelter. If we behave impudently, then this shelter is torn off. The companions of the Prophet asked, O Prophet of Allah, how can this shelter be torn off? By your tongue, by talking ill of others, by telling lies. And if there's some foolish person who disturbs you and tries to quarrel with you or fight with you, don't pay him in the same coin if you're fasting. That way you'll waste your fast. You can, of course, tell him, even angrily, that, look, I'm fasting. And that's the end of it. It means if you are behaving impudently and foolishly, I cannot. If you are abusing me, I cannot. If you want to quarrel and fight with me, I cannot. So this is a fasting person, that he's under a shelter. It's a shield. And this shield keeps him away from foolish acts, keeps him away from fighting or quarreling or abusing or telling lies. Then the Prophet, peace be upon him, swears on Allah the Almighty, says by him, in whose hand is my soul, that a foul smell, the foul smell which comes out of the stomach of a fasting person, is dearer to you, dearer to Allah the Almighty, than musk. Actually, it means that Allah the Almighty loves a fasting person. When you love a person, you love everything in him. Even you love his weaknesses also. Foul smell is a weakness from the mouth of a person. It's a weakness. It's not a good point. But this weak point is due to his worship of Allah the Almighty, due to his fasting. So Allah the Almighty loves a fasting person along with the whole of his personality. Even the foul smell. And here, gentlemen, don't be mistaken. Some people think that one should not clean his teeth. The foul smell coming out of a fasting person is not coming out of his dirty teeth. No, it comes out of his empty stomach. It's a strange smell. It's not the dirty smell coming out of the dirty teeth. No. One must clean his teeth while fasting. Then one very important thing. Allah the Almighty says, look at this man who is fasting. He has left his meals. He has left his drinks. He has left his pleasures. And he's left his desires for my sake. So all other deeds, good deeds, are bad deeds, which he has been doing will be recorded by the angels. And the reward would be given by me, of course, but through the angels, by my workers. But as-sawmu li wa ana ajzibi, the act of fasting is particularly for my sake, because for my sake he has left his daily routine of life. He's left eating, he's left drinking, he's left desires. Then this is a very silent and sincere type of worship. You're fasting. Nobody else knows that you're fasting or you're not fasting. If you're praying in a mosque, everybody knows it. If you're giving somebody charity, everybody knows it. If you're going to Hajj, to Makkah, everybody knows it. But if you're fasting, nobody knows it. Not even your wife. Might be that you have taken meals in the morning and you keep on taking meals at the daytime. You drink or you eat silently while you are alone. Nobody knows it. So it's a very silent worship. It needs